हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। सो यस्टरडे वी हैव स्टार्टेड न्यू टॉपिक सक्सेसिव डिफरेंशिएशन। इन दैट वी हैव डिराइव्ड nth डेरिवेशन फॉर सम स्टैंडर्ड फंक्शन। सो नेक्स्ट वी कंसीडर अनदर फंक्शन y इक्वल्स टू 1 डिवाइड बाय ax प्लस b पावर m। ओके, सो फ्रॉम द nth डेरिवेटिव ऑफ ax प्लस b रेज टू m वी हैव दैट इज dn ऑफ nth derivative of ax plus b power m। In that derivative we got m into m minus 1, m minus 2 and so on, m minus n plus 1 a raised to n ax plus b power m minus n। So this is from the nth derivative of ax plus b raised to m। So if I replace this m by minus b, that means let m be a negative that is consider m equals to minus p where p is positive, then this equation becomes dn of ax plus b power m equals to, you have to replace it by minus p, which becomes here it becomes minus p minus p minus 1 minus p minus 2 and so on, minus p minus n plus 1 a raised to n as it is, here it becomes ax plus b power minus p minus n, or now this can be written as dn of, I take this to the denominator, it becomes 1 divided by ax plus b power p, and all these terms we take minus 1 common, so it has n terms, therefore minus 1 power we can write n because we are taking n times common from all these bracket, so then this becomes plus, that is p into p plus 1, p plus 2 and so on, p plus n minus 1 a raised to n ax plus b power, it can be written as minus of p plus n, or you can take this to the denominator also. So then, so this can be written as dn of 1 divided by ax plus b power p can be written as, so here we add few terms here, so that is both the denominator and numerator we multiply by 1, 2, 3 up to p minus 1 times, so remaining all these terms same, that is both numerator and denominator we are multiply by 1, 2, 3 into p minus 1 terms, so remaining all these terms same, that is p into p plus 1, p plus 2 and so on, this p plus n minus 1 remains same, an as it is, so this I take to the denominator ax plus b power p plus n. Okay, so this I am taking to the denominator. Now, so why we have added divided and multiplied by these terms, means because in order to represent it into factorial form, therefore here we get minus 1 raised to n, now it can be written as p plus n minus 1 factorial, so that is it can be written as, so first sorry, so it started 1 2 3 p minus 1 p plus 2 p plus 3 up to pn plus 1, so therefore the last term is p plus n minus 1, therefore it is p plus n minus 1 factorial, and denominator p minus 1, p minus 1 factorial a power n as it is, 1 divided by ax plus b power p plus n as it is. Now I replace this p by m, then we get, So that is simply we just replace this p, all p terms in terms of m. Don't substitute p is equals to minus m. So simply here we directly got this nth derivative of ax plus b power m. So that means, so it is like that a 1 divided by ax plus b power m. So simply you replace this p by m. Okay, so then in that means you just represent it by in terms of m. So then you will get d power 1 divided by ax plus b power m. So here remember that I am just representing p terms in terms of m, because all the standard form in terms of m and k only, or you can keep this like as it is. Okay, m. So minus 1 raised to n m plus n minus 1 factorial divided by m minus 1 factorial a raised to n 1 divided by ax plus b power m plus n. This is the nth derivative of this 1 divided by ax plus b raised to m. Next, y equals to log of ax plus b. So differentiating this with respect to x, we get y1 is equals to, we know that log of x differentiation is 1 divided by x, therefore it is ax plus b. Into here we have to write differentiation of this ax plus b, which is equals to 1 divided by ax plus b. Differentiation of this one is a, therefore y1 equals to, we get a into 1 divided by ax plus b, or this can be taken to the numerator, that is ax plus b power minus 1. Now again differentiating with respect to x, we get y2 is equals to, this a remains same, this its differentiation is, because power is minus 1, we write it as minus 1 into ax plus b raised to minus 1, minus 1 equals to minus 2, into differentiation of this bracket is a only. Okay, so therefore we can write it as this minus 1 can be written as minus 1 into plus 1. Okay, and this ax plus b minus 2, as it is a into a, we write here a square. This is y2 differentiation. So similarly, again differentiating with respect to x, we get y3 equals to, so you observe that, so here this minus 1 into 1, as it is this ax plus b power minus 2 differentiation is minus 2 into ax plus b power minus 2, a square, same differentiation of this bracket is a. So that means we can write it as minus 1. So again from this term also we take minus 1 outside, so it becomes minus 1 into minus 1 equals to minus 1 whole square. So then 1 into 2 ax plus b minus 2 a into a cube. So like this, if I represent it in general term, so first you observe the terms. So in the third differentiation we got minus 1 power 2 and 1 into 2 and power ax plus b power minus 2 a power 3. So in the place of 3 we have 3, in the place of 3 here we have power 2. That means if it is n, it becomes n minus 1, if it is n, it becomes, so here we have minus n minus 1, therefore here we write minus of n minus 1. So we represent it in general form as, so this is minus 3. So representing in general form, we get, so in general yn equals to, so this becomes minus 1 raised to n. Here we got two terms, so for n we get n minus 1 terms, that is 1 into 2 into up to n minus 1 terms. So ax plus b power we get minus n and this a power n. So this is the nth term, therefore it can be written as yn equals to minus 1 raised to n remains same. So this can be represented as n minus 1 factorial. into ax plus b power minus 1 we take to the denominator power, it becomes plus n, and into this a raised to n. So this is the nth derivative of log of ax plus b power, sorry, log of ax plus b. Next we find the nth derivative of y equals to sine of ax plus b. So differentiating this one with respect to x, we get y1 equals to sine differentiation is cos of ax plus b into, we have to write differentiation of this bracket ax plus b. So sorry, this is d by dx of, we write d by dx of this ax plus b, which is equals to cos of ax plus b, differentiation of this one is a. So I will write here a. But so this is sine function, therefore we try to represent this function also in terms of sine. So we know that sine of pi by 2 plus theta is equals to cos theta, or cos of pi by 2 plus theta equals to sine theta. So therefore we use this, represent this cos of ax plus b theta in terms of, so therefore this cos of ax plus b can be written as, first we write this theta, so that means sine of, so theta means we consider this term, so this is the theta, so ax plus b plus pi by 2. So instead of writing pi by 2 plus theta, I am writing a theta plus pi by 2. Okay, so that means y1 can be written as a as it is, cos of ax plus b can be written as sine of ax plus b plus pi by 2. So similarly, again differentiating with respect to x, we get y2 is equals to y a as it is, sine differentiation cos of whatever this function ax plus b pi by 2. Next we have to write differentiation of this bracket, that is d by dx of this ax plus b plus pi by 2, which is equals to, here differentiation of this one is simply a into a, we get a square cos of this ax plus b plus pi by 2. Okay, again before going to third time differentiation, we represent it in terms of sine only. So then we get y2 is equals to a square sine, it can be represented in terms of sine as sine of pi by 2 plus theta, or theta plus pi by 2. So here ax plus b plus this pi by 2 as it is, this is this angle, plus we have to add one more pi by 2 here, pi by 2. So that means it becomes y square sine of ax plus b, so pi by 2 plus pi by 2 is 2 times pi by 2. Okay, so similarly on this basis we can write y3 is equals to, here we get y cube sine of ax plus b, this same, so here we get 3 times of pi by 2. Okay, so and so on. If we differentiate m times, in general we get, in general by n we get a power n sine of ax plus b plus this is n times pi by 2. So this is the nth differentiation of sine of ax plus b, that is nth differentiation of sine of ax plus b is equals to a raised to n sine of ax plus b plus n times of pi by 2, or we can simply write n pi by 2. So this is the nth differentiation of sine of ax plus b. Note, so sometimes we have only y equals to sine theta or sine x, then so that means all a is equals to 1 and b equals to 0, where a equals to 1 and b equals to 0. Substitute a equals to 1, b equals to 0 in this above equation, we get dn of sine of x equals to a equals to 1, 1 power n equals to 1 only, sine of a is equals to 1. So here we get b equals to 0, so simply we get x plus n pi by 2. So this is the nth differentiation of sine x. So similarly, you can derive the equation for y equals to cos of ax plus b. You try this by yourself. So here also, after differentiating, you transform the cos terms, sine terms in terms of cos. Okay, by using the same formula, that is cos theta is cos of pi by 2 plus theta equals to sine theta. Okay, so represent by using this function. You will get nth differentiation of this cos of ax plus b is equals to an cos of ax plus b plus n pi by 2. So almost similar to that sine of ax plus b. Okay. Next function, y equals to e raised to ax sine of bx plus c. Differentiating with respect to x by applying UV rule, treat this as u and this as v, we get y1 equals to e raised to ax as it is sine of bx plus c. Here we have to write bx plus c differentiation, that is b plus. Now sine of bx plus c, same, that is second function, as it is differentiation of first function e raised to ax into a. In the both term, we can take e raised to ax common, then it can be written as, sorry, sine differentiation is, this is cos. We can write it as b cos of bx plus c plus a sine of bx plus c. Now put a equals to r cos theta and b equals to r sin theta, then r square becomes a square plus, so this becomes a square plus b square. This is known things in the complex number. So then r can be written as root of a square plus b square, and this y theta is equals to tan theta equals to, we know that b by a, or theta is equals to tan inverse of b by a. Okay, so then y1 becomes e raised to, keep this ax as it is, only here in this place b and a, put r equals to r cos theta, a equals to r cos theta and b equals to r sin theta. Here b equals to, we write r sin theta into cos of bx plus c plus, again a means it is r cos theta into sin of bx plus c as it is. In the both terms, we can take r common, r into e raised to ax, we write it as sin theta cos of bx plus c plus cos theta sin of bx plus c. Now it is in the form of sin a cos b plus cos a sin b form. Therefore, we use that formula. So that is sin a cos b plus cos a sin b is equal to sin of a plus b. So here a equals to theta and this is bx plus b, bx plus c. Therefore, it is sin of theta plus bx plus c. This is y1. You can observe that. So in order to get y1, we have multiplied the given function by r and added the angle by theta. So that means, so here we write this result implies that the derivative y1 can be obtained by, that is obtained by function y on multiplying it by r, so multiplying by r and increasing the angle by theta, so repeating the same procedure. We get, so for y1 we have multiplied angle, so multiplied the given function by r and increase the angle by theta. So again same, in order to get y2 we repeat the same procedure, that means the same function we multiply with r and add angle, increase the angle by theta. That multiplying with r we get r into r square, e raised to x remains same, sine of, here instead of theta we get theta plus theta equals to 2 theta, plus the remaining angle is same, bx plus c. Again we have multiplied by r and increase the angle by theta. So similarly y3 can be obtained by the same procedure, that is increase by angle multiply by r, that we get r cube and remaining all the terms same, only increase the angle by theta. 2 theta plus theta equals to, we get 3 theta bx plus c. So in general, so repeating the same procedure up to n terms, we get in general yn equals to r raised to n e raised to ax sine of, here we can write it as bx plus c plus n theta. So this is the nth derivative of e raised to ax sine of bx plus c, where this r represents square root of a square plus b square and theta represent tan inverse of b by a. So similarly we can derive the formula for this, the function y equals to e raised to ax cos of bx plus c. Here also we use the same concept, so that is differentiating with respect to x we get y1 equals to, applying UV rule we get first function as it is, differentiation of second function, that means here we get b minus, because cos differentiation is minus sign, therefore sine of bx plus c into differentiation of this bracket is b plus sine of, sorry, cos of bx plus c as it is, e raised to ax as it is into a. So here taking e raised to ax common, we get first, we write this first this term first, a cos of ax bx plus c minus b sine of bx plus c. Again here also we substitute a equals to r cos theta and b equals to r sine theta, so squaring on both sides and adding we get r value, that is a square plus b square, and theta value is equals to tan inverse of b by a. So then y1 becomes here e raised to ax as it is, a value we substitute r cos theta and this cos of bx plus c remains same, minus b means r sin theta into this sin of bx plus c remains same. So here we can take r common e raised to ax, then it becomes cos theta cos of bx plus c minus sin theta sin of bx plus b. Now it is in the form of cos a cos b minus sin a sin b, that is cos of a minus b formula. So using cos of a minus b formula, we have cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. So then this becomes y1 becomes r into e raised to ax cos of a minus b cos of theta plus, sorry, this is not minus, this is a plus b, cos of theta plus bx plus c. So then so again same here, y1 the derivative y1 is obtained by function y by multiplying it by r and increasing angle by theta and repeating the same procedure we get y2 value. y2 equals to r into r square e raised to ax cos of, here we get 2 theta plus bx plus c. Again y3 we get r cube e raised to ax cos of, again adding by an angle theta we get 3 theta, or it can be written as bx plus c plus 3 theta. So in general yn equals to r raised to n e raised to ax cos of bx plus c n theta, where r equals to square root of a square plus b square and theta equals to tan inverse of b by a. So this is the nth derivative of the function y equals to e raised to ax cos of bx plus c. So in the next class we solve some problems on these standard formulas. Okay.